The Army never returned our phone calls, but that doesn't mean we're not going to go up there. And that's in Virginia, and we should go up to Connecticut and show the gun confiscation. My issue is I've only got like four reporters, and I don't have the infrastructure or the money right now to constantly send everybody everywhere. I mean, gun owners up there should be up in arms politically to reverse this. I mean, this is really happening. I appreciate your call. People should at least get this article out to everybody, bare minimum. Let's go ahead and talk to Rick in Utah. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, you there?
Yes, sir.
Hey, yeah, actually, I just wanted to remind you about Mike Lee up here. He is trying to repeal Obamacare. And, of course, he was one that tried to defund it in the first place. But there's a lot of great video on YouTube with Mike Lee and the argument about Obamacare. And there's a really great one. It's listed here as Obama's crack pipe. There's some great videos on that. And then I had one other comment that I had is the guy that was saying, well, what do we do? You know, and I agree. You're the info warrior, the guy that gives us that information. Once we have that information, then we need to take it to our congressmen, our senators, and start getting politically involved in our local governments. And that's actually what I've done is I've sat down and talked to with our congressman and our senator. Grant, they only give you 15 minutes, but hey, if you can get 15 minutes in front of a congressman, it's better.
Exactly. When they go out to these meet and greets, when they go around everywhere, you tell them, how dare you not repeal this? How dare you not take action against it? Thank you, Rick. Jerome in Texas, you're on the air.
Yes, Alex, this is Jerome in Austin, Texas, and I have a couple things I want to talk about. One thing is Obamacare. I'm recently retired from the motion picture business. I was in entertainment at Universal Studios for 20 years.
Hey, I'm not ignoring you. The police chief just stormed the office with a SWAT team. I'm going to come back to you. Hey, Austin Police Chief Art Acevedo is in here with us right now, and he's come to confiscate the guns.
I am all pro the Second Amendment. Every time I'm here, I have to get that out of the way.
I'm just teasing you. Anyways, how is everything going?
Good. We haven't had any controversy in the last 24 hours, so it's a good morning so far.
I ran into a police officer the other day that said he works at night, and you were out at 2 o'clock in the morning doing calls with him.
I do that on a regular basis, yeah. I was worked Saturday night. I was supposed to stay out till about 3, but it was so busy, I really didn't get home until 6 in the morning.
You have made international news.
You're going to have to bring it up.
With your comment, we have a clip of it. Here, you don't have headphones, but you know what you said. I actually played this earlier and said, really what you're saying is kind of true. You know, at least the police here aren't raping people with toilet plungers or raping women. But there you're admitting, though, that in North Korea and Mexico and Nigeria, the police are not too good.
Listen, police is imperfect everywhere in the world because the human condition is imperfect. And, you know, I wish I could go back and take back that analogy because people that want to hate on the police, that want to create more mistrust of the police, have turned that into at least she wasn't raped, which is absolutely not was not on my mind. That is not what I meant. But, you know, it is what it is.
No, in fairness, I actually agree with what you said, but I can see how they took it out of context. You're saying, hey, usually it's a controversy of rape or corruption.
I mean,
at least this is just them, you know, taking a woman to jail.
Yeah, listen, there's a lot of misconceived notions on what happened there. This was people saw a lady just sitting there screaming on the top. All that video shows is a young lady sitting down screaming, using profanity.
For those that don't know, she was jogging and couldn't hear them saying stop.
Well, she passed an officer's. We weren't there to write tickets. We were there to try to get these young people to make better choices. We had, within a couple of hours of that incident, we had another young lady or male, I don't remember if it was a man or a woman, go across the street in front of a bus, got hit by a bus. The next day we had three more people.
It is true that the bikes and pedestrians do run out in front of cars all day downtown.
It's crazy. And so the bottom line is she did not get arrested for carrying an ID. You don't have to carry an ID in the state of Texas when you're a pedestrian or when you're riding your bike. But if the officers are going to write you a ticket, you have to say who you are so they can write you the ticket. You can sign your promise to appear, and you're on your way.
The answer is like the Running Man. If we all wore explosive necklaces, when she didn't stop, they just blow her head off.
No, that's not the answer.
The TSA is actually looking at taser bracelets to fly. Would you like to put a taser bracelet on yourself?
No, I'm not sure that I'd be very interested in that at all.
Why not have explosives at birth planted in the brain so if the government's mad at you, they just hit a button like Snake Plissken?
God, I love you.
Have you seen Escape from New York?
That's one of my favorite movies. I love that movie. That's a great movie. The original. I didn't like the Escape from L.A.
No, the Escape from L.A. wasn't that good.
But it's been too long. I miss you guys.
Hey, talk about yourself a little bit. Your dad worked for the CIA in gun running against Fidel Castro, and now you work to get the guns here in America.
No, first of all, let me just say this, make it real clear. I will never support a gun control. I don't think that that's the answer. For me, it's more important to ensure that we do what we can to keep guns in the hands of law-abiding Americans of sound mind. And it's not about different weapon system. It's about making sure we do our best to keep them in the right hands. And that's law-abiding people, people that aren't crazy and people that aren't felons.
All right, now I've got you about another 15 minutes or so.
That's it?
We appreciate you coming. You can stay longer if you want.
I want to stay longer.
We're going into overdrive.
I want my full hour.
Your full hour?
I want my full
hour. I look like a hippie. I'm supposed to get a haircut at 3.
That's okay.
I have turned into a hippie. We'll be right back.
When you need it the most, will your generator, power equipment, or vehicle be ready? Gas and diesel fuels go bad quickly when stored, and more than half of generator failures during disasters occur as a result of expired fuel. PRI Fuel Stabilizer keep your fuel fresh for when you need it most. Nuclear power stations, emergency service providers, and ships at sea rely on PRI fuel stabilizers. And you can too. Call 888-776-9373 or visit priproducts.com to find the dealer nearest you.
My name is Jessica Armand. I'm an activist, a GCN listener, and mother of three. Our drinking water and food are filled with fluoride and other contaminants that harm our teeth and gums. To protect my family, I created My Magic Mud, an all-natural teeth whitening and strengthening remedy. My Magic Mud is a soft powder that polishes your teeth, reduces sensitivity, and removes harmful toxins from deep inside your mouth. You deserve a bright, healthy smile. Visit MyMagicMud.com and get yours today. That's MyMagicMud.com.
To thank you for being a loyal listener, we have a limited time freebie offer for you. Claim your free heirloom tomato seeds, just pay shipping, right now at 123freeseeds.com. These aren't ordinary seeds. These are heirloom, non-genetically modified super seeds that are open pollinated and can be grown, harvested, and replanted endlessly. These survival seeds are actually more valuable than gold in a crisis. Go to 123freeseeds.com and you can get an airtight storage packet of 150 super seeds free while supplies last to say thank you for being a loyal listener. First come, first served. Just cover shipping. Go to 123freeseeds.com now to see if your free heirloom seeds are still available. That's 123freeseeds.com.
The globalist social engineers are not just targeting us with propaganda. They are manipulating our genetics. We are being targeted at every level by estrogen mimickers that lower our testosterone and other hormones and natural compounds that the body needs. After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic super male vitality formula sourced from powerful organic herbs and then concentrated for maximum potency. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
Brings us in. Maybe Art Acevedo, the awesome police chief, is really a robot. Are you a robot?
Of things, robots not one of them. I've been called communist and fascist.
Who did that?
And everybody. I had some,
including me.
Some guy from including you. But you know better. You know that I'm actually a pretty moderate guy.
Hey, seriously though, we have the clip of you talking about this woman that got arrested for not stopping when she ran across the street jaywalking.
Jaywalking. It's jaywalking is mid-block. It was for crossing against the red, not obeying a a traffic control device.
Oh, so crossing across a red. Okay.
Yeah.
So here is the clip that's gone nationwide from Japan to England of him saying, at least our officers aren't raping people. Here it is.
That's not what I said, but that's okay.
Austin, Texas, that we actually had the audacity to touch somebody by the arm and tell them, oh my goodness, Austin police, we're trying to get your attention. In other cities, cops are actually committing sexual assaults on duty. So I thank God that this is what passes for a controversy in Austin, Texas.
So in other cities, they're actually having sexual assaults. You're glad that this passes as a controversy.
Well, listen, I would never... It breaks my heart in the time of instant information, anytime a police officer falls short around the globe, because we're all painted with the same wide brush. And it was a bad analogy because I didn't know at the time, but it ended up being twisted. But, you know, Austin, life's about points of reference. Austin is such a great city, and our department is such a good department.
Well, I've been all over the country. I have to say the police are nicer in Austin than almost every other city.
Well, thanks.
I mean, the big cities. And the small cities are usually pretty nice.
And Alex, over the years, you've been a soldier for InfoWars, and you've confronted our cops, and they've never really put their hands on you. They've always been pretty professional, even before I got here. I've seen a lot of the videos, and, you know, the frustration for me is this. I hold my cops to a very high standard. Our officers here get fired for things, and in a lot of departments they don't. And then this is the controversy. You don't get the option of opting out of a ticket by refusing to give your name.
I hear you, but here is the controversy, and then we're going to bring in the new Molon Labe women's shirt for your wife. Would you like a come and take it, your 300 shirt?
Well, let me see what it looks like.
We've got it. Bring it in here. The gold shirts, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, Arde Saveda, let's get a shot. Hold it up there. Product placement. With the Austin Police Chief. Hold it in front of the camera. Camera's right over here. See? Right there. Oh. And does that not look good or what?
Yeah, it looks like the 300.
Yeah, and it's got the M4s crossed there. You think your wife will like that? Yeah. Is that the right size for her?
Yeah, that's fine.
You got any daughters? What about daughters?
We've got Ana Sabana out there that would love
one. Let's give her one. Bring her in here. Bring your assistant in here. The lovely police chief assistant.
She won't come in.
Come on in here. Well, hey, we're going to give it to her, though.
Yeah, give it to her. Yes.
Come on. I mean, just available at InfoWarsStore.com. Helps fund the operation. Hey, you see the new studio? You like it?
It is fantastic. It's phenomenal.
It's too busy to ever launch it.
Well, when are you going to launch it?
That's really small. That's like a small woman. I'm going to launch it in the next couple of weeks. We got a bunch of cable systems ready to pick it up. Let me ask you a serious question. I heard you a few months ago on the morning show with Sergeant Sam say, quote, follow police orders, even if you think they're unlawful, and you won't get hurt.
Well, I mean, if you look at... police officers generally, and I can speak to 28 years of experience, generally are responding to the actions of somebody. That's why our use of force policy is called response to resistance. I tell my kids, you don't fight a battle with the cops on the street. If you've been mistreated or you think you got falsely arrested or the ticket's not valid, there's a process to do that. And so I always tell them is that we take our grievances through the courts, through the police monitor's office, through internal affairs, but you just don't do it on the street. And, you know, it really saddens me when I see folks running from the police. You know, they get themselves hurt over silly violations. And in Austin, Texas, might get you a slap on the wrist and you're putting yourself at risk running. It's just, it's something that has...
Or it might get you shot in the back.
Well, you know, I mean, nothing good comes from running from the police either on foot.
I'll tell you what, back in 60 seconds, let's continue there with Police Chief Arde Saveda. Overdrive, Infowars.com/show, PrisonPlanet.tv. Stay with us.
Today.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formulation, fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com.